अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम साजिद अली। टुडेज़ अवर टॉपिक खिलाफत मूवमेंट। इट वाज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम 1919 to 1923। सो डियर फ्रेंड्स, व्हाट वर रीजंस बिहाइंड खिलाफत मूवमेंट, व्हाई इट वाज स्टार्टेड एंड हु वर मेजर लीडर्स इन खिलाफत मूवमेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस। So dear friends, at first background, its history we should explain. Indian Muslims, what was the role of Indian Muslims in Khilafat movement and Khilafat? What was Khilafat? Khilafat was a Islamic state in which some major pious and holy institutions were. So in Khilafat Makkah, the region of Makkah, Medina, Syria, Middle Eastern regions, countries, Palestine, Jerusalem, all regions were in Khilafat territory. So a single Khalifa ruled over the all regions. All these regions, areas were pious for Muslims. As we know, Muslims were living in India also. And what were reasons behind Khilafat movement? Why Indian Muslims launched Khilafat movement against British? Because at that time in India, it was the government of British and India was the colony of Britain. Indian Muslims launched the Khilafat movement to secure, to save Ottoman Empire, Turkey, Khilafat. In Khilafat, in other words, it was also called Ottoman Empire. Ottoman Empire, its center, its capital was Turkey. So dear friends, in Ottoman Empire, all these regions were, holy for Muslims. And Ottoman Empire supported Germany. We are discussing causes. In World War I, it was started in 1914. When World War I started, Ottoman Empire supported Germany. And World War I was fought between powerful countries just like Britain, Great Britain, Russia, France and other powerful countries, and other countries like Germany, Austria, Turkey. Turkey is a Ottoman Empire. So in World War I, Ottoman Empire helped Germany. In this way, in World War I, these regions, these countries, Germany, Austria, Turkey and other small countries lost the World War I. On the other hand, Great Britain, France, Russia and other powerful countries won the World War I. In this way, after the victory of World War I, winner countries decided about the defeated countries, defeated areas. So in this way, they decided at first to divide them into small states, into small countries, to reduce their powers. So dear friends, Britain decided to divide, split up all these countries. In this way, they passed some treaties. Treaty of Versailles. It was passed in 1920. According to Treaty of Versailles, Germany and Austria were divided, split up. So, dear friends, when Germany and Austria were divided, Indian Muslims were attached to Ottoman Empire religiously. They realized about the future of Ottoman Empire because Ottoman Empire was in World War First and it supported Germany. According to Treaty of Versailles, Germany was divided, including Austria. So they realized if Great Britain would divide Ottoman Empire, so it would be injustice with Muslims, because at the time of First World War, Britain decided to seek to take help from Indian Muslims. So Indian Muslims helped Britain in First World War because Great Britain said them that we will maintain Ottoman Empire if we will won First World War and if we will not divide Ottoman Empire. But Britain did not do so. When they won First World War, they decided to divide defeated countries, defeated states. In this way, Indian Muslims realized it would be injustice for Muslims if Britain will decide to divide Ottoman Empire. So, dear friends, finally, Ottoman Empire was divided. According to Treaty of Sevres, Ottoman Empire was divided. It was passed in 1920 May. So, dear friends, Ottoman Empire was divided in this way. Mesopotamia, Syria, and Palestine were under League of Nations. And these regions were given to France and Britain by League of Nations. In this way, Ottoman Empire was divided. Some Turkish land was also given to Greece also. So, dear friends, Arabia became independent. Treaty of Lausanne. What was the Treaty of Lausanne? When Ottoman Empire was divided, Turkish rebelled against Britain after the Treaty of Sevres. So, Treaty of Sevres was replaced with Treaty of Lausanne in 1923. Some regions were returned to Turkish. So, dear friends, in this way, Ottoman Empire was divided. Germany and Austria were also split up. So, dear friends, non-cooperation movement. What was non-cooperation movement? It was a movement against British government in India. It was launched by Muslims at first, and they issued a fatwa, a religious decree. On that decree, 500 Muslims signed to boycott against British government its goods. So dear friends, in non-cooperation movement, Gandhi was also supported. Gandhi also supported Muslims, and Gandhi was a leader of Hindus. When Gandhi supported Muslims in the cause of Khilafat movement, so Hindus automatically supported Muslims. Hindus were in majority in subcontinent. So when Hindus supported Muslims, automatically Muslims became powerful in non-cooperation movement. So dear friends, it was the first movement when Hindus and Muslims together to launch a movement against British government in India. And Gandhi also told to Muslims of India that you should support Congress and its aim, its objective to take self-rule from British government. Muslims supported Gandhi's decision, Hindus, and Hindus supported Muslims. In this way, in non-cooperation movement, Hindus and Muslims were together against British government in India for a same cause in Khilafat movement. So dear friends, Hijrat movement, what was Hijrat movement? When these circumstances started, so some Muslim leaders, Islamic leaders, ulamas introduced a religious decree fatwa to migrate from India to Afghanistan. They called India Darul Harab. In those ulamas, major of them, Abul Kalam Azad and Abdul Bari Firangi, both ulamas were major in introducing fatwa to migrate from India to Afghanistan. When they introduce such fatwa, such religious decree, about 18,000 Muslims migrated to Afghanistan. At first they realized, they thought it is good for them. So, but finally it was not good for them, because when they started migration from India to Afghanistan, they suffered so many difficulties. In this way, Muslims migrated from India to Afghanistan. It was not good decision of Muslim ulamas, according to some writers. So dear friend, what was Mopla revolt? Moplas was a tribe, a Arabian tribe. They launched a revolution against British government for the cause of Khilafat movement. But as a result, they were killed. Hundreds of Moplas were killed. They were Muslims. And hundreds of them were arrested, also injured. So dear friends, what was Chora Chori incident? Chora Chori incident चोरा चोरी दिस इज़ अ रीजन ऑफ गोरखपुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट इन इंडिया. In Chora Chori, a mob of people, a group of people started a strike, a protest against British government. In a strike, they also set fire a police station where about 21 police persons, officials were killed. Because of Chora Chori incident, Gandhi decided to call off non-cooperation movement. Because Gandhi was a single leader in non-cooperation movement of Muslims and Hindus and a Khilafat movement leaders. So after Chora Chori incident, when 21 policemen were killed by a mob of people and they set fire a police station, Gandhi stopped non-cooperation movement. When Gandhi decided to stop, to call off non-cooperation movement, automatically Khilafat movement was ended. So dear friends, when Khilafat movement was ended, Khilafat was also became weak. Ottoman Empire was divided. So when Ottoman Empire was divided, Khilafat was weak. So the last Khalifa was Muhammad VI. And Ataturk Kemal, who was a person who abolished Khilafat. Ataturk Kemal, who abolished Khilafat totally in 1924. Now he established a democratic government in Turkey. So dear friends, in this way we discuss Khilafat movement, what were its reasons and its background history, some treaties after the First World War. Those treaties were adopted, and according to these treaties, some defeated regions, empires, countries were divided to make them weak, and non-cooperation movement, Hijrat movement and other topics related with Khilafat movement. So dear friends, take care, thank you, Allah Hafiz.